today we have an unusual assembly, a fellowship of two mothers. One is pretty old, the other is rather young. But if you look closely, this is the coming together of two testaments. At this point, Elizabeth represents the Old Testament. Mary stands for the New. And when Elizabeth hugs Mary, it is Old Testament hugging the New Testament. It's a very wonderful situation. If you read it closely, try to understand the inner meaning of what is happening there. It's a very, very beautiful scene. Modern times, nowadays we don't use it, but we used to talk about generation gap, differences between generations. Now, one purpose for which John the Baptist came to the world, as said in the last part of the last book in the Old Testament, Malachi, that John came to reconcile generations, to turn the hearts and minds of young people towards the older one, and to turn the hearts and minds of the older people towards the young. In our language, we can say this is the mission of John the Baptist, reconciling generation. We know and acknowledge this is an urgent need in every age, reconciling generation, because history is a continuity, it is a flow. Today follows yesterday, and tomorrow follows today. There is no break. We say today is today, tomorrow is tomorrow, yesterday is yesterday. No. East is the east and west is the way, the twain shall never meet. It is Chinese way of saying it. But we know east will meet the west. So here is an assembly of the old and the new. The new is born out of the old. Remember that. It is not the new all on a sudden comes out suddenly on a fine morning. No. It is the continuation of what happened yesterday. Now our friend there is singing. Somebody taught him to sing. Not that one fine morning he woke up and started singing. No. He learned to sing. So what we are today, what we do today, is the result of all the things, the inventions, discoveries accrued to this moment. Even science is that. Science is also a progression. So the fellowship between Elizabeth and Mary is the coming together of the Old Testament and the New Testament. Remember that these two ladies, one is pretty old as I said, they respect each other. The second purpose for which Mary came to Elizabeth's house, number one, to say hello to her. Number two, to serve her. Shushrushika. And St. Luke specifically says, for almost 3 months, Mary stayed with Elizabeth. What does it mean? Till almost the birth of John the Baptist. For 3 months, Mary was with Elizabeth, ministering unto her. This is ministry. This is wonderful. We need to read these lines into it. Read between lines. Mary visited Elizabeth as directed by Archangel Gabriel, just to greet her, to show her respect. Plus, she wanted to stay with Elizabeth, which means Jesus is staying with John the Baptist. Mary is staying with Elizabeth. Now, this is the actual fellowship. What happens when two people meet? Normally, we think otherwise. In this situation, Elizabeth may become the laughing stock of the community because she is almost 100 years old, something around that. But how can a grandma, she is not still a mother, but has the age of a grandma, how can she give birth to a child? So people start laughing. In the Syriac language, you have heard about Bar Hebraeus, Bar Hebraea. There's a book by Bar Hebraea, Laughable Stories. I don't know, I have a copy with me, but it's available elsewhere, I have no idea. So this is a laughable story. This pretty, pretty old woman is going to give birth to a child. And his son, people start smiling. What is happening here? In such a situation, she kept aloof from the community for almost 5 months. It is said in the Gospels that Elizabeth, she was hiding, almost physically hiding in a place because people will start laughing. That is her situation. Look at Mary. If we look closely, Mary is in a very, very critical situation. It's a very risky situation. So she is happy. What is the risk? When an unmarried girl is to give birth to a child, that is the end of the story. She'll be stoned to death. That is what the law, Mosaic law says, that person will be stoned to death. She's condemned to die. She knows that. But she is happy. How can you explain that? When Mary meets Elizabeth, she is overflowing with joy. Again, this becomes unbelievable. Now, I want to ask a question to myself and a question to you all individually. Is it possible to be happy when you are most sorrowful? Is it possible to be conscious of sorrow when you are at the zenith, cloud nine of happiness? These are jargons used today, cloud nine on top. But knowledgeable people tell us that the consciousness of death at the moment of extreme joy, that is the meaning of life. The conscience of joy at the zenith of Zoro is the meaning of life. For me, both these are the same. Consciousness of sorrow, death, at the time of general happiness, and the consciousness of joy in an environment of all-round sorrow. This is the reality of life. Here, Mary is in a very, very risky situation, but she is happy. Elizabeth confronts her, "You are the mother of God. How come that the mother of my Lord is coming to me?" Perhaps Elizabeth is the first person to call Mary Theotokos, Deva Madhava, the mother of my Lord. We are just repeating it. You know, some Protestant churches never use the word mother of God, Theotokos in Greek. But Elizabeth uses, "This is the mother of my Lord." So she is happy. And Mary becomes a prophetess at that point. Elizabeth also becomes a prophetess. Elizabeth says, "You are blessed because you believed what you are told by God." And Mary says, "People will call me blessed." That is why even today we call Bhagyavati. Generations to come will address me as blessed. By whom? Blessed by God. "You are filled with God's grace." What did Archangel Gabriel tell Mary? "Hail Mary, full of grace. Maryam, you are full of the grace of God." Deva Kribayana Nanme and Allah Prayogichirikinda Devatinda Kriba. "Mary, you are filled with the grace of God." Devatinda Karunyamunda Kribagundan in Aranyirikin. Now she is filled with the Holy Spirit. She is full of the grace and mercy of God. And she becomes a prophetess and repeats the very same words which she read in the scriptures, where the mother of Samuel, Hannah, when she repeats these words in the Old Testament, you can go, if you are interested, you can go to the beginning part of the book of 1 Samuel, where Hannah says this. This will happen to people who are proud. This will happen to people who are humble and poor. The very same words are repeated by Mary. What does it show? Mary, she never went to a university, but she knew the scripture very well. She read the Bible. All ladies here, all the gentlemen sitting here, boys and girls, if available, this is the lesson to be learned from Saint Mary, the mother of God, our own mother. So she was well versed in the Bible. If you are diffident to read the Bible, look at Saint Mary. She was an adolescent, but she's an expert in the scriptures. How can she remember the exact words which Hannah recited in very, very olden days before Eli, the priest? So we have two women here, wonderful women. One is very young, the other is pretty old. And they greet each other, and that is the Bible. The Old Testament coming and greeting the New Testament, and John the Baptist is standing in between the Old Testament and the New Testament. Remember, with one hand he touches the Old Testament, with the other hand he touches the New Testament. Even Jesus Christ praises John the Baptist. There is no one greater than John the Baptist born of a woman. Anything more than that? That is the greatest praise heaped on John the Baptist. In turn, John the Baptist says, "Here goes the Son of God. I am just the morning star. He is the real sun coming behind me. I'm not eligible to untie the lace of his shoe. I'm less than his slave." That is what he says. So they mutually praise. For us, that is the lesson. All the relationship, human relationship, is based on mutual respect. Remember that. Jesus respects his forerunner. John respects most his Lord Jesus Christ. His mother and his mother, both mothers, when they hug each other, that is a lesson for us. Let us be one. Let us start reading the Bible. Let us pay respect to Saint Mary and Elizabeth. I learned so many things from them. May the grace of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, and the intercession of Saint John, the intercession of Elizabeth, and Saint Mary be with us all now and forevermore. Amen.